Welcome to this MedTool video tutorial. In this tutorial, I will show you how the MedTool graphic user interface is composed. I will explain the idea behind MedTool, show the structure, and also go through the menus. To understand the idea behind MedTool, one should note that MedTool is nothing else than a script manager. But what is a script? For example, if you're looking at the script, which has a simple task to compute the area of a circle. Then what we can do, we can write a script, which we called, for example, circleArea.py, which is a Python script. We pass a radius to the script, and maybe we write the output to a file. The code could look like this. This is a Python code, where we get the radius from the arguments, we calculate the area, and we print something to the output. If you'd like to have a manager which is able to handle such a script, then this is MedTool. In MedTool, usually here in the script browser, you see the name of the script or a shortcut of the name. The parameters are here in the script's parameters option. For example, the radius is here. The output option is here. We see the output option here can be activated or non-activated. That means this argument here is optional. And the print of this can be seen here. That means this is the output area which gives us the output of the script. I've already opened here the MedTool help. And also next to it, I opened a MedTool graphic user interface. So the MedTool help has here as a second section the graphic user interface. If you click into this section, there's also one important thing. The graphic user interface, what you see on the right hand side, is composed of many scripts. The scripts only write or read data from the database. That means the MedTool database is very lightweight and never stores data. Only the script are storing or reading data. The graphic user interface structure that we see here has four main sections. The first section, the script browser, the script parameters, the viewer, and the script output section. So let's open a script we have from a previous project. And what can be seen here is in the script browser, we have the script names. Here in the script parameters, we see the different parameters, for example, file names, or in case of segmentation, we have here segmentation parameters. The editor, the viewer first. In the viewer, we can simply open data files to visualize them. We have here next to the viewer the possibility to scale the image, to change this contrast, to overlay an image, change the overlay options. Here, we can clear the overlay. If you click on the image here, we get information about the image. And we can also segment using this row selection. If I'm simply clicking here, and I can simply segment the, I can get the bounding box for cropping the image with the medical image processor script. The editor is a text editor, which can be used to write some text. The spreadsheet editor is used for parameter studies. It's more or less a simplified spreadsheet. And the directory manager already gives me an idea about my data. I can generate here directories, and most important, I can generate here automatically a folder structure. I can also quickly navigate between the work and the home directory. So this is this area. In this area here, we have the script output. So whenever we let the script run, we get here some output of the script. I can, for example, clear this output area. I can also save the output area or looking for strings in the output area. For example, read. I'm getting here the entries with read. What's next? So, coming to the graphic user interface, we saw already how this looks like. Let's come to the script basics. Whenever we create a new script, and let's create here, for example, a new image processor script, it first asks me for a file name. So it's important, the file name, if you cannot start with a number, so if you try to do this, then there comes an error. So what you have to do, you have to start with an underline. This is the reason is because underneath is an XML database. So I usually like to number these things, and I give the script a name, and the script is generated on the script browser. And we can start modifying the entries in the script. There's also something which is called the info here. What I can do under extras, there is an info text script, which I can call, give here a name, C, for example. What is the advantage? If I have this sectioning here, I can simply switch on and off only the section that is underneath this thing. So this is quite a handy tool if you have a huge script. Let's explain a bit more what we see here on this side. So in this script values, usually these entries are having different possibilities. So the first thing, if you, for example, click here, this is an optional value which can be switched on and off by clicking here. The next thing is here, if I'm changing the text, it's recognizing here the file format. So if the file format is known, it gives you here the format. If you'd like to have the default option, you can simply click here, you get back to the default option. If you'd like to get an help on the option, you simply click this button here and we get a quick help here in the output area. There is not the need to go to the manual. Here, usually you can select files. Also here are the file formats. There are also other types of input entries. For example, here they are so-called a split entry. So that means you have exactly here the number of entries. You cannot delete the entries. Always three entries are required. So I recommend here to edit on this side. So this is about this area. And now finally go over the menus. So what we see here, if we have the script names here, first the file menu. The file menu where you can, for example, make a new script. Don't like to save this. I can open a script like the script we had before. I can update the script. This is sometimes necessary if there is a new version and new options are coming to the script. You can view a template. This is a template where you can start with if you'd like to have a new plugin with all the options in it. You can import or export marked sections. So if you'd like to export only this script or these two scripts, you can do so by simply saying export this to a new part of the database, and you can open this then, or you can import this again here if you come from another file. You can save it, the database save as, or you can add a plugin. So you can add your own script here to MedTool. The edit option, you can move scripts up and down, but of course this is easier by simply drag and drop the thing here. You can delete a script or rename a script. For example, also here with the right mouse button or with this one here, you can simply say your name. You can copy the things, or of course you can delete it. You can also switch here, check all, unchecked all all on, all off. And you can query replace parameters. For example, if you say here, you have in this script a parameter, a name which is called image. You'd like to replace this. You simply go here to query replace. You say find image and replace this by image 2. You can have the active script, all scripts. If you say apply, you see the name is changing. So flipping this back. And that's it. After that, they're starting the entries from image to extras, and these are the scripts. So these are the scripts which are manipulating the data. So we have an image processor script, MPI version of the script. We can calibrate the images. We can convert DICOMs, and we can also create here FE files. There's a measure, 2D measure for ISO surfaces, or 3D measure, Seagull measure or the bone measure, and the converter of mesh files. The material section is allowed to interpolate the material data from CD images. The boundary condition are usually used for homogenizations. We can solve. We have Calculix, an interface to Calculix directly, and also to Abacus. In the Linux version, there's also an interface to Parasol. We can post-process Abacus, Calculix, and do analysis with the results. We have the analyzer, where we can analyze the stiffness tensors, fabric tensors, histomorphometry, that means trabecular thickness, trabecular spacing. We can analyze or we can generate DEXA images from CD images and analyze them, and we can analyze grid data. The publisher menu can do report making and also XY plotting. Fabricate is for 3D printing and also visualizing surfaces. And finally, the extras menu, where you can query and replace parameters and files. You can merge CSV files, spreadsheet files. You can run scripts directly from MedTool, or you can create these info text entries. And then there comes the plugins. So usually this is only there if you already added plugins, but these are my own plugins, which I can simply open and use them as they would be scripts coming from MedTool. So after that, we have the run section. So the run section again is here in this toolbox. So what can we do? We can, if we come over it, there comes the help, run only the active. So this runs now only the active script. We can say run all checked. So if all are checked, all scripts will run. If I click out, for example, the visualization, it runs the script. I see it here by this flag. And if I'd like to run all scripts, I run this script, and then it continues with this script, but it will not run this script because this is not active. Then there is also the option of a parameter run. So this allows you to replace, for example, names here by parameters, but there will be a separate tutorial explaining this. Settings means if you click here, you can change the settings here, for example, the working directory or the parameter files, which we're not using yet. Also, you see here the Python executable from the MedTool, which you can use in your project, also for other Python programming. Then finally, the view. So in the view, what you can do, you can open a second image viewer. That means it works exactly in the same way like the first image viewer, but you have a little bit more space and can have, of course, both images here next to each other to compare them. What you can also do here is you can open a separate editor to edit text file. And finally, you have a MedTool viewer. So if you open this, this window opens also if you don't have a valid license. You can simply open MedTool files and view them, but you cannot manipulate and change anything on the files, but at least you can view them and see the parameters, and you can have in this way more than only one script open, but you can only run with one license, one script. You can also check the license info with this help. And finally, the help. With the help, you can on first check the license info. So you get here the information of the license and you see the expired date. So in case you need a new license, please contact me. And you can also use this for license update. So if you get a new license file, you simply update the license by this new file. You get an information about help, about MedTool, about Qt, which is and you get here a help about OSCript. So usually this is not needed, but in case you'd like to search here for a help, but usually you're using either the help of the ActiveScript or you're using this help here.